Back now with Ronal Serpas, the superintendent of the New Orleans Police Department. Earlier, you mentioned a lot of restructuring issues, a lot of changes. Kind of go into some detail about some changes that we may have for the future. You mentioned maybe working with violent offenses or with other police departments across the area.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, the first important thing for our department is to deal with violent crime every day. It's our number one priority. But behind that immediately comes quality of life. Not every neighborhood in New Orleans, violent crime is the problem, so we will never ignore those neighborhoods. We will never tell a neighborhood what we think is important. We need them to tell us what they think is important. I went to a meeting this week with some neighbors in Holly Grove, Uptown area. It was a great meeting because we want to listen to what they think. Now, back to the violent crime piece. There are a handful of people in any community in America who have chosen a violent lifestyle. They have also chosen that they do not want to be rehabilitated. They have also chosen that they are going to make you their victim. Well, we're going to make them our focus. We're going to work very carefully inside our department to stand up a violent offenders unit, and that unit will work very closely with Mr. Canizzaro and his staff to identify these repeat violent offenders who don't want the benefit of rehabilitation. We're going to work very closely with surrounding agencies. I had a tremendous meeting this week with Sheriff Newell Norman, and there's a lot of interplay between the sheriff and Jefferson and the City of New Orleans Police Department because criminals don't know where the 17th Street Canal is. They may not know where the West Bank Expressway is, and we need to continue to nurture those relationships. We have a great relationship with all the federal agencies, law enforcement, FBI, ATF, DEA. We're going to continue to point to these agencies and say, we all have a small number of violent people. Let's do everything we can to help ourselves, to help you help us get them.
And you've also said in the past that you all have wanted to really, like you said, immerse yourself into the community. You spoke with folks from Holly Grove. Tell us about the efforts that you're doing on the ground in the communities, going door to door, talking to folks, getting their input and getting their help, really.
Good thing. Two things we've done differently. One is our crime prevention unit has been retasked. Our crime prevention unit now is doing what if you call cold calls. In other words, they're going to businesses and residences that we have no relationship with that we can identify. And we're talking to them, and our crime prevention unit is saying, look, here's some information from Crime Stoppers, a great partnership with Darlene Kazanza and her crew. Here's some information from Crime Stoppers. Here's how we can get you in touch with our brand new community coordinating sergeant that each district has now. That community coordinating sergeant then picks that lead up, if you will, not unlike an insurance company. I mean, picks that cold call lead up, and then they develop the relationship of here's what our crime prevention methods are. Here's what our neighborhood watch, business watch programs are. Here's the district commander and the leadership team. Come on in. Come on in. Help us help you.
You've also mentioned in the past restructuring the districts, mm-hmm. putting police officers where they're most needed. How is that coming along?
Well, one of the things I'm excited about is when we did the reorganization 2 weeks ago, we had about 27, 28 motorcycles that were working in a centralized unit, and districts would have to kind of like, you know, raise their hand like a little school child and say, oh, can I please get your help? No, we're not doing that. We took those motorcycle resources and put them under control of district commanders because we believe that the district commander is the person most likely to solve the problem, not someone in headquarters, not someone who's not involved with the district relationships. We moved the mounted unit to the French Quarter Central Business District. Many communities do it that way because that's where the issues are, and why not leave that resource where it belongs? This is the beginning of a thoughtful process over the next 2, 3, 4, 5 years where we are always going to find a way to put resources under the control of the district commanders so that they can actually solve somebody's problem. There's the link. If we can solve somebody's problem, we've made a new supporter. We've made someone believe that we can help them. They'll help us. It happens every time.
Now, are there any major upcoming changes that we haven't heard from you all yet?
We're going to do some announcements in the next couple of weeks about 5 or 6 different initiatives that we're moving forward with. Mayor Landrieu and I have a plan on some different things he and I want to talk about.
Can you go into any specifics on that?
No, not on TV.
Of course not. Okay. Nah.
But what we want to do is this. We are going to be a responsive community mm-hmm. that's respectful of the people we serve. And if you are not willing to be respectful of the people we serve, I'm telling you now, find someplace else to work. There's no room for anyone here who doesn't realize that the service of policing is the most noble profession on the planet. And with that carries a tremendous responsibility. And that responsibility is to treat people as you would expect to be treated, treat people as you would expect to make a new supporter. And every time you do that, this department will advance itself.
Superintendent Ronal Serpas, thank you so much for joining us again. It's always a pleasure getting your updates on the police department, and we'll see you again real soon.
Thank